Yeah, so this is the structure of once the panels are joined. Now there's a little bit of a discrepancy here. This part of the garment is sort of standing out too much, and what will happen is when it's worn, it'll be like a bulging end around here, and we need that angled out. Also, it looks like it's a slightly tighter crease. Obviously, we were limited on the fabric. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have to add a little bit of like a little bit of an extension on the front side, just to give it. Now the front part of it is okay, it's just the back. I didn't cut too deep, and in a way it's good because now we can take that part away, and that's where the sort of bulging would have come out from. Also, with this particular suit, I've got salwar, so to make this into like a good match, what I'm going to do with this suit is I'm going to make it into like an open camise rather than making it like a frock type, because an open type camise with like gauge looks better. And also I'm going to sort of angle that out so that it's more of a beautiful round gear and the edges are not drooping. Okay, so that's the back of the camise. Also, I need to slightly angle down on the shoulders and also cut the neckline. Now I would suggest doing these minor cuts and so on once your panels are connected. Now it looks a little bit short, but because we're going to have a nice thick border, it should be just right. Now this is the actual back of the dress. Now coming to the front of the dress, the shape of it, it looks more or less right. From here it's got a good angle, but from here it looks just a little bit tight, and I'm also going to slightly round it off. So it is at this point that you want to give your garment the final cutting. I did slightly cut it here, which perhaps I shouldn't have. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to attach the neckline on, turn it towards the right side. Once I've attached this piece, then I'm going to attach the piece that I want the extension with. So what we need to do is search out our pieces, which I actually hastily picked them all up and threw them in the bin. So I think I prefer to perhaps use this. So I need two pieces like this. So once we've done that, we're going to attach that to the side here, just to slightly give it a little bit of an extension. Most of this will be hidden in the seam, but I don't, you know, she is a little bit plump, so I don't really want it to. And then I will leave, I like probably guards up to sort of that level. I'll close it up to there, and then I'll just leave a little bit of guards. It is wide enough, but I just want to make sure that I don't end up making it tight for her. I think it should be fine. That is going to make a gorgeous outfit. Now with the sleeves, I've also attached all the pieces and so on. And once all the pieces have been attached, what I've done is I've shaped them and basically got a beautiful sleeve, and the trims and so off just look like they're all laced and stuff, and it's all part of the pattern. So good patterns, I wouldn't suggest wasting away the pieces. It's amazing the kind of results you can get. This is just one of those outfits, right, which totally, you know, 1¼ yards, and the rest of it is all totally made from leftover pieces, and it's just amazing what you can actually do with the pieces. So with this, my battery is about to run out, so I'll continue just showing you. I'm going to put this on the right sides, both the right sides up, and stitch this along, notch into it, and then turn it up the right way, and hopefully that will be the neckline done. I want to keep it as simple as possible and make the work as less as possible, and hopefully it shouldn't be too long, and we've got a complete dress.